you tell me who would fill out the paperwork inside a hospital? Okay, you think a doctor's going to fill out paperwork?
No.
It could be the nurse, or who else does the, there's a person, a title for a person that does the... Ward clerk. Ward clerk. Okay, fills out the paperwork. Another name for a ward clerk would be hospital unit clerk or unit secretary, okay? They're the ones that fills out the paperwork always, okay? So again, who will fill out this paperwork?
The ward clerk.
Very good. And we have to check, everybody's double checking somebody else. You get what I mean? So we have to read this and make sure it's filled out appropriately. And of course, it would need to have a patient's full name, their date of birth, and the MRN number, okay? Now, on the lower part here, you'll see where it says on the very top, check one box only. You see that? Check one box only right here about midway, right where my finger is. Mm-hmm. Now, why that is important is because you don't want one box to cancel out another box, or one box and the other, if you check another one, it doesn't make sense. It no longer makes sense. You understand what I mean by that? So, referring to, you can have a within 4 hour, you find that one, that box checked, as long as you don't have, a hold sample. It no longer makes sense. Do you get that? Because a hold sample, the blood center is going to session it in and do nothing with that sample unless it's ordered. If you have a type in screen, then a blood center will type in screen of blood, but again, they won't try to package up units because no units are ordered. Do you get that? Yes? So again, make sure that one box doesn't cancel out another box. Okay. Now, in the lower part to where you see three lines, you'll see where someone, it says on the below, person completing requests, right? So again, who do you think will sign there?
The ward clerk.
The ward clerk. All right. Now, if we can look at the instructions, you'll notice, the longer sheet, you'll notice that it says the instruction for the nurse is to come in a patient's room with you, and the nurse is going to read off letter by letter the last name, the date of birth, and the MRN number. While the nurse is reading it out loud, letter by letter, the phlebotomist is looking at the patient name on a form and on a label and making sure it matches 100%. When she's reading the MRN number, looking to make sure it matches 100%. Date of birth, looking to make sure the labels and a form matches. You get that? Mm-hmm. Okay, so once the phlebotomist and the nurse agrees, that is the ID, then the nurse is going to sign that second line. Okay? Mm-hmm. Then the nurse can leave. So they don't have to be there for you to draw the blood. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, again, the bottom line, it says person drawing blood, date and time. So that's going to be who? You, exactly. So that's where you would sign. Now let's go to the far right of the form, top area. You'll see it's asking for the who's ordering the blood. So they want the doctor's name there, okay? Again, we're not filling out any information. We just have to make sure the information is there. Okay, we're double-checking the ward clerk right now, okay? Mm-hmm. The next line you'll see it says diagnosis or procedure. So there you'll see maybe like an arrow pointing downward, HCT. What do you think that stands for? Put myself out there.
Low hematocrit,
very good. The next line is asking, where is the, what's the telephone number for the patient inside your facility? Oh, excuse me, not the telephone number of the patient. Telephone number of the unit where the patient is located. You get what I mean by that? Where's the huck? Because it's better that if the blood center had questions, that they can call directly to the floor instead of calling the lab, because if they had questions, we have to transfer them up where? To the floor. You get that? Mm-hmm. So if the blood center had questions, if they knew the phone number, they can call directly to that floor. Okay?